Good evening. Welcome to Current Affairs. In today's session, let's look at two different concepts. First one is the Millennium Development Goals, and that has been transformed to Sustainable Development Goals. So now there is no concept of Millennium Development Goals, otherwise called MDGs, but you have Sustainable Development Goals. If you go back to the year 2000, in the year 2000, in the United Nations, a decision has been taken that goals must be set for the entire world, meaning all the members of United Nations must achieve certain goals by the year 2015, and 8 goals were prescribed over there, and they are expected to be attained by all the nations by the year 2015. And they were called Millennium Development Goals, and the number was 8. There were 8 goals, but unfortunately most of the countries, rather no country, could achieve this. That is the reason why during another meeting in the year 2015, it has been revised, it has been named as Sustainable Development Goals, meaning SDGs have come into the picture in the year 2015, and the targeted year is 2030. By the year 2030, all the members of United Nations are expected to achieve these goals, and they are called Sustainable Development Goals. Clear? And SDGs, Sustainable Development Goals, are 17 in number. MDGs 8, SDGs, they are 17 in number. Please remember these points, and what is the latest information with respect to this, I am going to show you now. Now, look at this. I am opening the document. Look at this. As per the State of India's Environment Report of 2021, the latest one, State of India's Environment Report of 2021, what is the rank of India in Sustainable Development Goals? Right? 1, 2, 3, 4, it's a 58th, 89th, 92nd, or 117th rank. Right? Please remember, for this particular report of the year 2021, India's rank is 117. 117. Look at this. According to the state of this report, India's rank has been dropped by 2 places. So this is one important one. India's rank has been dropped by 2 places to 117th as compared to 2020. Meaning, in 2020 rankings, India was at 115th position, and now it has been dropped to 117. Is that okay? And when it comes to sustainable development goals were adopted as a part of 2030 agenda, or it is popularly called Agenda 2030. It was adopted by United Nations. How many members are there in the United Nations? 193 countries are members in United Nations. And it was adopted in the year 2015. Please remember, MDGs, Millennium Development Goals, were adopted in the year 2000. And the number was 8. Now, in 2015, 17 SDGs were adopted, and that is the part of the Agenda 2030. Clear? And in the year 2020, India's rank was 115 and has dropped by 2 places because of the major challenges pertaining to SDG 2, meaning Sustainable Development Goal number 2, Sustainable Development Goal number 5, Sustainable Development Goal number 9. Clear? Totally, how many are there? Out of these 17, India has faced certain major challenges with respect to number 2, number 5 and number 9. So what are they? I would like to show you now. Please have a look at this. Look at this now. Right. So if you look at, you know, number 2, that is zero hunger. If you look at number 5, that is gender equality. And if you look at SDG 9, so that is industry, innovation and infrastructure. So number 2, number 5 and number 9, and please remember it will change from year to year, and whatever the information that I am giving it to you, that is the latest one and this is applicable for this year. Am I clear? And out of total 17, India is facing challenges with respect to 3, SDG 2, 5 and 9. Am I clear? And please remember all the points with respect to this. So let's move to the next one, another very important one, because nowadays, because of this, you know, health issues that are being faced, Ayushman Bharat is gaining lots of, you know, importance. When it was announced by the central government, some of the states they refused to be part of Ayushman Bharat. Because every state has got its own, you know, this health schemes. And when we have our own scheme, what is the necessity of the central government scheme? But the current situation of pandemic forced the states to accept this Ayushman Bharat, and now it is being implemented in almost all the states now. I would like to show you the information regarding this. Look at this now. Under Ayushman Bharat, health and wellness centers is it for primary health care, secondary health care, tertiary health care, or none of the above? Please remember, there are two components under Ayushman Bharat, and one is health and wellness centers. Clear? So there is a and that falls under the primary health care. That falls under the primary health care. This is very, very, very important one. Look at this. Ayushman Bharat has got two components. Health and wellness centers for comprehensive primary health care, and Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana for the secondary and tertiary health. Please remember these points. And both seek to deliver healthcare services closer to where people live in both rural and urban areas. So please remember this one. It has got two components. One is health and wellness centers. Second one is the Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. Right? So please remember all these points. So that's all for the day. I'll see you in the next class. Thank you so much for being with me.